6-Minute Grammar from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to 6-Minute Grammar with me, Catherine.
And me, Neil. Hello.
In this programme, we're talking about state verbs. We'll explain what they are.
We'll show you how to use them.
We'll give you lots of examples.
And we'll finish with a quiz to see what you've learned.
So, let's get started. We can separate English verbs into two groups, state verbs and action verbs. Most verbs are action verbs.
And, of course, action verbs describe actions. So verbs like go, kick, watch, rain are all action verbs. And we can use them in any tense we want. Past, present, future, perfect, passive, continuous. The lot.
Yes, but state verbs are different because we don't usually use them in the continuous tenses.
That's right. We don't use state verbs in tenses that use the ing form, such as the present continuous and the past continuous.
Right. Now, you're probably asking what kind of verbs are state verbs. Well, there are three main types. The first type, verbs that describe feelings and attitudes, such as love, hate, like, and prefer. Here's Harry with an example.
What's this music? I like it.
Thanks, Harry. In that example, Harry's talking about his feelings now, but he doesn't say, I'm liking it.
No, I'm liking is the present continuous tense, and with state verbs, that's usually wrong. We'll say a bit more about this later on, but the general rule is, use the present simple for verbs of feeling, like love, like, and hate.
Now for the second type of state verb, that's verbs of thinking.
So, verbs like think, know, believe, understand, remember. Here are some examples.
I believe Andrew's living in Dubai now. Do you remember if he's married?
Good. In this example, Harry's using the present simple tense with the verbs believe and remember. You can't use them in the continuous.
And the third group of state verbs are verbs that describe senses. Verbs like see, smell, taste, hear, and sound. Another example, please, Harry.
What are you eating? It smells delicious.
So Harry says it smells delicious and not it's smelling delicious.
Exactly. That would be wrong because smell is a state verb.
It is. And as well as these three main types, there are some other common state verbs. For example, have, own, belong.
Want, need, mean.
Cost, seem, appear, and wish.
Well, that's quite a lot of verbs to remember, but one way to decide if a verb is a state verb is to ask yourself, does it describe an action?
Mm-hmm, good tip. And if the answer is no, it doesn't, then it's probably a state verb.
6-Minute Grammar from bbclearningenglish.com.
And we're looking at state verbs. Okay, so far? Good. Now, a couple of points to make.
Yes, a few verbs can have two meanings. In one meaning, they're an action verb, so you can use them in the present continuous.
But in the other meaning, they're state verbs, so you can't use a continuous tense. Some examples, please, Harry.
Mick looks like his sister.
And?
Mick's looking at his sister.
Thanks. So, in the first example, Mick looks like his sister. Look is a state verb. We're talking about Mick's appearance, not his actions.
But in the second example, Mick's looking at his sister, Mick's doing something. So in this sentence, look is an action verb.
Another verb with two meanings like this is have. For example, I have a cat, but I'm having a bath.
And think. Listen, I think you're right, but I'm thinking of going to Spain. And all the sense verbs can have two meanings too. Another example, Harry?
Can you see that man?
And?
I'm seeing the doctor.
Right. Now, do you remember we said it's wrong to say I'm liking it because it's the present continuous? Well, You might hear this sometimes in very informal spoken English. Or you might hear, I'm hating this movie, or I'm loving your work. But only in very informal conversations.
Thanks for that, Neil. I'm loving your explanations. And now it's quiz time. Are these sentences correct or wrong? Number one, do you prefer jazz or rock music?
And that is correct. Prefer is a state verb, so we use the present simple tense. Do you prefer?
Well done. Number two, are you belonging to the football club?
That's not correct. Belong is a state verb. We have to say, do you belong, not are you belonging?
And number three, I'm having lunch with Kate today.
And that is correct. Have is an action verb here, so it's fine to use the present continuous tense. In this sentence, I'm having means I'm eating.
Well done if you got them all right. There's more about this on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. Join us again for more 6-Minute Grammar. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.